Thank you. Shay Shay. Arigato. How are you? I walked in earlier here. I heard Alan speaking, and I noticed how very quiet and gentle and polite you were being. And I hope you're not going to be that way with me. Are you feeling good this morning? Good. It's really a privilege to be back here. I haven't been back here since 2004, so almost 3 years. And during those 3 years, I've done a lot of living, and as you have, I'm sure, and lived a lot of different experiences. So I'm excited today to share with you some distinctions that I know can make a difference in the quality of your life. Huge difference. And that's not making an exaggeration. But anything I'm going to tell you is going to be a total waste of your time if you just sit and listen to me passively. How many of you have ever gone to a seminar or a university or an educational environment and you learned something and you knew it was really valuable, you believed it was valuable, no one was selling you on it, you knew it was important, you were excited about what you learned, and then you never actually applied what you did in any way? How many have ever done this before? Say I. How many have done this more than once in your life? Say I. How many still feel intelligent? Say I. So one thing that I've learned over the years, and I start every seminar the same way, no matter what the subject is that in order for you and I to get something that's valuable out of this day, out of this time, we're going to have to activate our minds and bodies. If we sit passively as we learn, even if we're enjoying what we're learning, we don't retain it. We may retain it intellectually, we may have our notes from it, but we don't actually follow through. So the first thing I want to say is, I'm excited to be here, but I'm also challenged. Because some of you, how many have ever been to a seminar of mine before? I'm curious. Wow, welcome back. Well, the shortest seminar I usually do is 50 hours, 5-0. We literally do a weekend of total immersion. And the reason I do that is because, you know, if you just hear something and it goes in and out of your head, it's interesting. But what I like to do is condition people so you build muscle, so you actually follow through. So here we've got about 3 hours. It's a very short period of time, but my excitement is I think I've got a format for you that'll really work. But for it to work, you're going to have to really engage your body. So a couple things are important. Research shows that if you sit and listen to me passively, within 4 weeks you'll remember less than 10% of what I said. And that's not because you don't have a good memory, it's just because the information, you're going through so much of your life with so much stimulation, it doesn't get retained. If you take that information and you just write it down, and nothing else, even if you never read the notes again, you'll retain about 30 or 40% of what you heard. Because the physical act of writing it down makes you draw the grooves deeper of what you've learned. And if you can physically activate your body while you're learning, if you can yell back the answers, if you can engage your nervous system, then you retain about 85 to 90% of what you've heard. So I really want to make sure you came here, you get what you came here for. So I'm going to ask you to do something that in the beginning might feel a little different, which is to be much more animated in your response. And the reason for that is, you know, if all of us in this room have had a problem, and that is we all went to a 20th century school. In a 20th century school, you are basically being trained to be educated for a 20th century job, which in those days was an industrialized job, right? So what happened when you went to school? The bell rang and you got trained. Even as a little kid, when the bell rings, what do? Report to your desk, your chair. And when you get there, what are you supposed to do? Sit down there and shut up. Don't talk to your neighbor. Don't do anything until someone tells you what to do. Well, today we live in the 21st century. As corny as that may sound, and if today you sit and you're in business and you don't talk to your neighbor, you're out of business. If you wait for someone to tell you what to do, someone else is going to be succeeding and you're going to be waiting. How many would agree with me on this? Say aye. So what I'm going to ask you to do is be much more active today, much more aggressive. When I was a kid, I was a talker, so I got in trouble. I remember I was in school and I had this one teacher that loved silence. So we'd have these periods where he said, there's no talking at all in class. And I'd be talking to my friend. And he used to assign me, I used to get in trouble, so he'd give me these assignments. A 10,000 word essay I would have to write, why I will not talk again in class. I wrote 6 of these 10,000 word essays, it didn't work. I remember I had my 10 year high school reunion. And I got to the reunion, there were 5 of my teachers there, one of them was that teacher. And I went up to him and I said, look, this talking thing worked out pretty good for me. So the mindset of using our bodies and using our voices is what I want you to get geared up for. Because if you're sitting here right now, and let's say you're sitting passively. When you're in school, how did you sit usually? In a peak learning state. And if you're sitting here right now while I'm speaking, and even if you're enjoying yourself, but you're in a passive state, the state of mind you're in gets linked to what you're learning. So if you could be sitting here and going, wow, I'm excited about this program, even though you're calm, Or you might be saying, man, he has giant teeth. I've never seen teeth that big before. Whatever you're saying, if you're in a casual state, a quiet state, you're going to have that information kind of come in and out. And later on, even if you've enjoyed it, you go, yeah, I really think I should do this. I should follow through. I should make this happen. Because you're passive. I'm going to ask you to become active. And the way we're going to do that is a couple ways. If I ask you a question, I'm going to ask, if you will, that you yell back the answer. Not so we have a bunch of positive thinking here. Because I don't just believe in positive thinking. I believe in intelligence. I believe in seeing things as they are and not lying to yourself. I believe seeing things as they are but not making it worse than it is, which is what most people do, so they don't have to try. And I believe in seeing it better than it is, and how do you close that gap? But to do it, you first got to activate yourself. So all those willing to use your body, and when I ask a question, yell back the answer, say I. Oh, now that was not very good at all. Do you understand why? Because if you engage your body, the engagement of your body will bring your energy up. If your energy is higher, you'll retain it. And if you keep on doing this, in the beginning it feels kind of weird, especially in Asia for some people. But after a while, you'll start to see it feed you energy. And when you have the energy, you're going to follow through. How many came here because there's some area of your life you really want to improve or change or become more successful in? How many came today for that reason? Raise your hand and say, I. If that's true, then the biggest thing we're going to do is from thinking about it into doing. And the way to do that is train your body to be more active. I'll give you a good metaphor for this. If you really want to learn rapidly, if you really want to change your life, the way that you do this is you become more like a kid. Because kids instinctively do the things that make them learn very rapidly. And one of the things about a kid is they have a certain amount of energy before we teach them to calm down and be a certain way. Isn't it true? So kids, when they're learning like crazy. And they're willing to learn because they're not worried about failing. If a kid falls down, they get back up again. But adults, if we fall down, we look around and say, anybody see that? Nope, I'm never doing that shit again. As adults, what we have to do is engage ourselves more. So today, I'm going to ask you and invite you to decide right now for this couple hours to be really effective that you're going to do things differently than you have in the past. Because in the past, you went to a seminar or you went to an educated place and you got good information and you didn't use it all because you were passive. I'm going to ask you to change that. And so a way of thinking about that is you don't have to think about age in terms of energy. Energy is something that's more psychology than it is age. Some people are very old, but they're very young in heart and they have tremendous energy. And you can tell how old somebody is by the way they move. Right? Do you ever watch a kid walk through the living room like this? They're walking along like this, dude, and all of a sudden they go, whoop! And they walk off for no reason right after it. Come on, who's ever done this when you're a kid? Raise your hand, say,